Hello everyone, welcome back to Chunda DIY, and this is my first tutorial of this new year. In today's video, I'll be showing you how to crochet a ribbed slim fit cardigan. It is really easy pattern and friendly for beginners. For this cardigan, I make for size small, and in this tutorial, I also showing you how to make the cardigan bigger and longer. Okay, now let's get into the video. First thing first, we are going to make the front part of the cardigan. To begin, make a slip knot. And chain 83. It is equal 16 inches length. It's the height of my cardigan. If you guys want your cardigan more longer, you can add more chains. After you got your desired fit, next, we are going to make the ribbing stitch. For row 1, skip 1 chain and make single crochet into the next chain. To make single crochet, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 2 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all 2 loops. Keep making single crochet into every chain until you reach the end of the row. Then we meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, and this is what the first row looks like. Next, for row 2, chain 1, turn your work. For chain 1, we don't count as a stitch, and then we are going to make single crochet, but into the back loop of the stitch only. Keep making single crochet back loop only into each stitch until you reach the end of the row, then we meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, and this is what the second row looks like. For the next row, please keep repeating row 2 until you reach row 19. It is equal 4 inches width. It's the measurement of the top of my shoulder. And if you guys want your cardigan more bigger, you can add more rows until you reach your shoulder measurement. Then we meet you back again. Thank you. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 19. Like I said, for this 19 rows, it is equal 4 inches. It's the measurement of the top of my shoulder. And next, count 32 stitches. Then use stitch marker to mark at the 33 stitch. For this 32 stitches, it is equal 6.5 inches length. It's the measurement of my neckline. If you guys want your neckline more deeper, you can count more stitches and mark it. And if you guys want your neckline more higher, you can count less stitch. You can try this piece on your body and use stitch marker to mark where you want the length of your neckline is. And next, continue from where your last stitch is. For row 20, chain 1, turn your work and make single crochet back loop only into each stitch until you reach the stitch marker. Then I will meet you back again. Next, for row 21 until row 32, chain 1, turn your work and make single crochet back loop only into each stitch until the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 32. For you guys that make bigger size, please keep making the ribbing stitch until you reach the middle part of your chest. And next, we are going to make the buttonholes. To begin, continue from where your last stitch is. For row 33, chain 1, turn your work and make single crochet back loop only into the next 4 stitches. After you got 4 stitches of single crochet back loop only, then chain 1. After you have made 1 chain, then skip 1 stitch and make single crochet back loop only into the next 9 stitches. If you guys use bigger button than mine, please make the buttonhole more bigger by chain 2 or chain 3 and then skip 2 stitches or 3 stitches depend on how many chains that you made. After you got 9 stitches of single crochet back loop only, then chain 1, skip 1 stitch, and we are going to repeat the same thing by making single crochet back loop only into the next 9 stitches. Then chain 1, skip 1 stitch, keep repeating this until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach the end of the row. Next, for row 34, chain 1, turn your work and make single crochet back loop only into each stitch until the end of the row, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And And this is what it looks like after you reach row 34. And next, please repeat the same thing to the other side, but you don't have to make the buttonhole again. Just make normal ribbing stitch for 34 rows. It is the same number like the first side. And now we are done for the front part of the cardigan. Next, we are going to make the back part of the cardigan. For the back part of the cardigan, it is the same thing like the front part. We start with chain 83. It is equal 16 inches length. It's the same height like the front part. And then make single crochet back loop only for 68 rows. And this is how you can get your back part measurement. You just plus the total rows of both front part together. For my front part, I have 34 rows for each side. So 34 plus 34, it is equal 68 rows. It's the measurement of my back part of the cardigan. And next, we are going to make the sleeves. It is the same thing like the back part or the front part of the cardigan. It's just a little bit different here. We want the upper part of the sleeves is more expand or wider than the wrist part. To begin, you just make 108 chains. It is equal 21 inches length. If you guys want your sleeves more longer, you can add more chains. And then for row 1, you just make single crochet into each stitch until you have 22 last stitches. After you had 22 last stitches, then we are going to make half double crochet. To make half double crochet, yarn over, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. Please use stitch marker to mark at this first half double crochet. It is easy to know where to start making the half double crochet. And next, keep making half double crochet into each chain until the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, and this is what it looks like. Next, for row 2, chain 2. For chain 2, we doesn't count as a stitch. Turn your work. Then we are going to make half double crochet, but into the back loop of the stitch only. Keep making half double crochet back loop only into each stitch until you reach the stitch marker. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the stitch marker, then we are going to continue make single crochet back loop only into each stitch until the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. And after you reach the end of the row, for row 3, chain 1, turn your work and make single crochet back loop only into each stitch until you reach the stitch marker. And then we are going to continue make half double crochet back loop only into each stitch until the end of the row. And for the next row, you just repeat row 2 and row 3 until you reach row 6. Then I will meet you back again. And after you got 6 rows of half the worker sheet, and next, for row 7 until row 40, chain 1, turn your work and make single crochet back loop only into each stitch until the end of the row. And then after you reach row 40, for you guys that make bigger size, you can try the sleeves around your arm. If it's still small, you can add more single crochet rows until it almost fit around your arm. And then we are going to make 6 rows of half double crochet by repeat row 2 and row 3. So for the total rows of my sleeves, I have 46 rows. And next, don't forget to repeat the same thing to the other sleeves. And now we are going to connect the front part and the back part of the cardigan together. Place both parts on top of each other and then we are going to attach the shoulder part. To begin, turn your work. Then attach the yarn into both sides loop. Chain 1, then we are going to make single crochet both sides together by insert the hook into both sides loop. Yarn over and pull through both loop. And now you have 2 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through 2 loops. Keep making single crochet both sides together into each stitch of the single crochet row until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. And after you reach the end of the row, chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And this is what it looks like. Next, turn your work and repeat the same thing to the other side. And now we are done connecting both sides together. And this is what it looks like. And next, we are going to attach the sleeves into the cardigan. To begin, fold the sleeves into 2 pieces and use stitch marker to mark at the middle part of it. And then place the stitch marker into the middle part of the cardigan, which is the shoulder part where we connected both sides together. And then attach the yarn and make single crochet both sides together into each stitch until the end of the row. And this is what it looks like after you have attached the sleeve into the cardigan. Please repeat the same thing to the other side. And next, fold the cardigan like this. And then we are going to attach this side of the cardigan until you reach the end of the sleeves. Then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach the end of the sleeves. Please repeat the same thing to the other side. And next, turn your cardigan right side out. And this is what the right side looks like. And next, we are going to sew the buttons into the cardigan. And now your Rib Slim Fit cardigan is done. If you like this tutorial, please don't forget to click like and leave a positive comment down below. Stay safe and stay healthy, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.